take that outside behind us. And indeed, appropriately enough and dead on cue, five teenagers who certainly aren't strapped for cash are in fact Take That. Their new single, Take That. Their new single is straight in at number two, and they're a big hit with Helen Atkinson Wood. Months ago, nobody had even heard of them. Now they're the biggest thing to take Manchester by storm, and the UK, and the world, and the universe. And they're gorgeous. If I should beat up there, I'll keep an open mind. Where's that? Come in. Get out. Take That.
Hello. Hey.
How did you all get together?
I think just by total luck, actually. I think it was just fate that we came together, and I've never been able to get rid of them since, actually. I mean, I don't know.
Were you all in pop groups before, or did you just meet each other on the street, or
we're
at a party?
Actually, I was in the Rolling Stones, Mick Jagger. I was born in a crossbar hurricane. It's me, Mick.
We're doing bits and bobs in various groups, but nothing like amazing, so we decided to try and make something good together. Type thing. Why can't I wake up with you? Why can't I wake up with you?
It was a bit of a gradual process, really, when we met each other, because I knew Mark before everybody else, so we were already friends. So I think it took 12 months, really, though, before we were working together full time. You know, we messed around, really, for 12 months, being lots of sort of doing that. And then when the work did start, you know, about a year ago, we did start working 24 hours a day business, you know, week in, week out. I think at the end of the day, though, we're pretty decent people, you know what I mean? And we do get on with everybody, you know, so it's no problem to get on with each other at all. We're having a good time as well, you know.
Jason, sex, drugs, rock and roll.
Let's talk about sex. Mm-hmm. Now, we did, when we promoted It Only Takes a Minute Girl, that was our first sort of big hit in the UK, we decided to have, like, chats and stuff with the kids about safe sex, about non-smoking, about whatever they want to chat about, really.
When we start off, we didn't set off to say we're pop stars, you got to do this, you got to do that. But we thought, you know, kids won't listen to, well, I say kids, young adults won't listen to teachers and politicians and people like that. And they look up to somebody like us. So given the chance, we've given something back to them to say, listen, you got to do this, you got to do that. But if it like saves one girl from getting pregnant underage, or one girl from getting AIDS, or one lad from getting pregnant, from getting AIDS, then, you know, we've achieved what we've set out to do.
You work a lot in clubs, and you're obviously very exposed to drugs. You also have a high public platform. Do you have a moral message?
Don't take drugs, you know, because they screw you up in the end, but I suppose the way we do our performance and on stage thing, the energy that goes into it, I mean, that's sort of saying something that, you know, if we took drugs, we wouldn't really be able to do this sort of thing.
I think if you do take drugs to get by that way, although you might be able to run faster, or inside, it is doing your body in, because, like, you think you've got all this energy, but your body's saying give up inside, you know what I mean? It's false energy, it just gives you a false buzz in a way.
All I can say is just say no. Blunder.
Why can't I wake up with you? Be there when I open my eyes.
here that she's changing her name to Helen Tate Atkinson Wood in tribute.
They're nice lads, aren't they?
They seem very nice, yeah. I just wish everybody would go home now.
You see, they're not live.
They're not live, we did
say. It was a tape. I don't believe it. That we're coming on. Right, after the break, the woman at the centre of the latest royal controversy, Leslie Player, is here live. She's talking about polo, passion, the Duchess of York, and, of course, Major Ronald Ferguson. That's next.